we see like the positives, right? We see everything, but has there been some pretty crazy times? Have you guys met some real opposition or anything?
Absolutely. And one thing that we're trying to do, so again, this has all happened so quick, mm-hmm. what the Lord's doing, that I'm trying to catch up to it, mm-hmm. and you know, really kind of put some infrastructure in place. One of the things that we're really trying to move towards is fully documenting what God is doing. Mm-hmm. So not just shooting when we're on the street, but really trying to keep cameras rolling all the time, and then make many documentary series. Oh, yeah. How do you say that?
Documentary series?
There you go.
Or docuseries? Docuseries, right?
That's the word I'm looking for. Make these mini docuseries that would then tell the story of God in L.A., tell the story of God in Dallas.
Yeah.
What he's doing on these trips is insane.
Yeah.
So to answer the question, we have seen some wild stuff. Michael where was it, dude? What was it? Mardi Gras, sorry. we were in the thick of it. So we were there the weekend before Fat Tuesday. Fat Tuesday is the culmination of Mardi Gras. So the weekend before and after are huge for the whole Mardi Gras season. So, I mean, it was wall to wall on Bourbon Street. You could literally barely move. It was so thick with people. It was one of the most chaotic environments that I've ever been in my life. And this guy came up to us early on in the night, was a tap bro, had tap dancing stuff on his shoes.
It's a tap dancer?
Tap dancing on the street, came up, you know, New Orleans, real oppressed, just people out there, just you can just see it all over them when they're really, really, you know, oppressed of the enemy. So anyways, he comes up, I could tell something was going on with him, but I didn't think much of it because everybody, their mama out there was lit up,
you know what I'm saying?
So he came up doing his thing. We started ministering to him. And he seemed real reasonable the first time we were ministering to him. He came back probably 30, 40 minutes later. And he was about to fall. He was about to stumble because he was lit up on some drug or something.
Yeah.
And my guy Michael just braced him for the fall because he's about to fall into our music gear too, his piano and everything. So we're just trying to stop him from falling so he wouldn't hurt himself and mess up our gear. And so then the dude just jumps in a huge fit of rage.
Wow.
I'm going to tell you that what the Lord does is crazy. So he goes and rears up to punch Michael in the face.
Ooh.
And two other guys are walking down the sidewalk.
Mm.
And they start calling him out, basically like, homie, you better watch it. And so they come up on him. And he moves on, gets all up in their face. There was nose to nose. And one of the other brothers basically was like, yo, homie, you want a bullet? Like, I'm about to cash you out right now if you want to be on your back, dog.
Ooh.
And so then when he said all that, dude jumped back. And then the guys with the guns came over to us and was like, bro, we know God sent y'all in this atmosphere.
What?
We're going to stand right here so this dude don't come back and mess with y'all.
Street security right
there. Yeah, bro. So I'm like, Lord, do it. Lord, do it.
So Mike's about to get hit in the face by a tap dancer.
Tap dancer shoes,
that would have been
tap
wild.
Tap dancer on meth.
Oh, man. That's the worst. Those are the worst ones, man.
Yep.
It wasn't put. Jeez. That's crazy.
So,
but one of my favorite clips, the dude was definitely drunk. You were like, he loves you. And he's like, you were hugging him. You probably have so many clips. I don't know if you remember, but I don't know where that was at. Was that Holly? Was that?
Was Orlando.
Okay.
Yeah, that clip was in Orlando. And I remember this was a monumental clip for me in my heart personally, because this was only our probably third or fourth time doing the stuff on the streets. And again, that boldness muscle, right? So I'm still trying to build it, still trying to lean into it. And so he and his crew came behind me and started mocking me initially in the camera.
Really? Wow.
And it's kind of making fun. You know what drunk people do, like when they don't understand, they just kind of go off or whatever. And so the Lord had me turn around and just start singing the song of the Lord over this dude. And his demeanor goes from mocking to like, dude, I need you out here. Like, you're literally changing my life right now. And then he gets real weird, pulls me in and gave me a kiss on my cheek. I'm like, dog, hold up. Like, you need me out here. That's cool. But kissing me, bro, you about to get jacked, homie. No.
Some holy hands.
Yeah, that was funny.
He was Hispanic. We showed the video here. After it was done, I was like, all right, whose cousin was that?
Come get him.
Whose cousin was that in here?
That's funny, man.
That's wild, man. But that was cool. You were singing over him and everything. Yeah. I mean, drunk as a skunk, but you were right there, man, just singing over him, ministering over him.
I think the Lord is showing me, the more I do it, the importance of the seed sown. I don't think oftentimes in the body, especially when we stay cooped up in the four walls, do we see the value of the seed scattered, right? And so, I've got a story, but I want to save it. I don't know why I want to save it, but I want to save it for a little bit later here in the talk. I think that if we would get to a place as kingdom people, of really understanding the value of the seed, we would make it our life's goal to scatter it everywhere we go.
Amen.
And so I don't know definitely what's happening in every single one of these scenarios.
Yeah.
But I do know that we are making a deposit.
Amen.
And it's real, it's authentic, and I know God's on it for sure. So that moment was for sure special.